This audio is brought to you by Muslim Central. Please consider donating to help cover our running costs and future projects by visiting www.muslimcentral.com/donate. دع الأيام تفعل ما تشاء وطب نفسا إذا حكم القضاء ولا تجزع لحادثة الليالي فما لحوادث الدنيا بقاء وكن رجلا على بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه ما بعد. إن شاء الله in today's short khatira, we haven't done tafsir for a while. We used to do tafsir, I remember, pre-COVID. Today I recited Surah Naba or Amma Yatasa'aloon. Obviously, we don't have time to do a detailed tafsir of the entire surah. But I think that it is important that all of us should know the general meaning of the surahs we recite in the salah. And this is going to increase our khushu' and allow us to appreciate the Quran as we recite it. Surah Naba is actually one of the most amazing and powerful surahs. And it is an early Meccan surah. And like all early Meccan surahs, it has what we'll call in English fiery eloquence. The eloquence is a very unique type. If you know, the Madani eloquence is different. The Madani eloquence is longer verses. The Makki eloquence, it is short verses that are generally speaking more rhythmic. And we find this in Surah Naba. And the theme of Surah Naba is actually one of the main themes of all of the Makki surahs, and therefore one of the main themes of the Quran. And that is to prove the Ba'ath or the resurrection. This is the main theme of Surah An-Naba. From beginning to end, it is all about proving and affirming this fundamental fact of our religion. And the Quraysh, the Meccans, Arabia overall, did not believe in a hereafter. They did not believe in a qiyamah, in heaven and hell. They did not believe in a resurrection of the soul. وَقَالُوا إِنْ هِيَ إِلَّا حَيَاتُنَا الدُّنْيَا نَمُوتُ وَنَحْيَا وَمَا نَحْنُ مَبْعُوثِينَ. They said, we have one life to live. We will live, we're going to die, we shall not be resurrected again. So one of the main goals of the entire Quran was to prove the reality of a hereafter. And this is a belief that separates the Abrahamic religions, Judaism, Christianity, Islam, from all other faith traditions. It is a fundamental pillar of our religion. And Surah Amma, Amma Tasa'aloon, it illustrates the many techniques that Allah uses in the Quran. Surah Naba summarizes all of the techniques of proving the Akhirah. And again, we don't have time to go over detail, but very briefly, what are they asking about? Amma Tasa'aloon. This is a rhetorical question to intrigue the listener. This is a rhetorical device. What type of question is this? What question are you asking? People are now paying attention. What is Allah asking that they are asking? عَمَّ يَتَسَأَلُونَ. Then Allah says, عَنِ النَّبَإِ الْعَظِيمِ. They're asking about the most magnificent news, the biggest news. Nothing more significant than the Day of Judgment will happen to us. The most significant event of the entire creation is the Day of Judgment. عَنِ النَّبَإِ الْعَظِيمِ. The biggest news and the biggest important event of our entire existence, the most decisive day, is going to be يوم القيامة. عَنِ النَّبَإِ الْعَظِيمِ الَّذِي هُمْ فِيهِ مُخْتَلِفُونَ. They are differing about it. Meaning, Allah has not differed about it. The prophets have not differed about it. You guys might be confused, but Allah is very clear. The Quran is clear. عَنِ النَّبَإِ الَّذِي هُمْ مُخْتَلِفُونَ كَلَّا سَيَعْلَمُونَ ثُمَّ كَلَّا سَيَعْلَمُونَ. This is one of the techniques of the Quran. The certainty with which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the Day of Judgment and affirms the Day of Judgment in contrast to the uncertainty. Because in the end of the day, just like agnostics, just like those who reject God, they're like, yeah, maybe there's a God, maybe there isn't. Maybe there's a hereafter, there isn't. This is an uncertainty. In contrast to this, the Quran always affirms with unambiguous equivalence. It's very firm. إي وربي إنه لحق. أي by Allah it is true. Right? So Allah Azza wa Jal affirms the Qiyamah with a certainty. We can call it a confidence that should shake those people who are agnostics, who are atheists, because they don't speak from certainty. How can a person negate there's going to be a qiyamah? You cannot negate it. It is your dhan, it is your presumption. So the Quran comes with a level of confidence, la rayba fi, that only Allah Azza wa Jal can have. Or else, how can we bring that? So Allah Azza wa Jal says, that kalla say'alamun thumma kalla say'alamun. This is one technique of the Quran. Another technique to prove the Day of Judgment is to discuss the miracle of creation and the miracle of life, two separate things. The miracle of overall, the harmony of the world, of the reality of existence, and also the miracle of life itself. This is a common theme throughout the Quran, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is challenging the intellect of those who deny Qiyamah. On what basis? Don't you see the miracle around you of life? Why would you think that the one who created life the way that it is cannot recreate it in another way in the next life? And so the next series of verses, 10 verses or so, talks about the miracle of life and the many examples of the reality of existence. كَلَّا سَيْعَلَمُونَ ثُمَّ كَلَّا سَيْعَلَمُونَ أَلَمْ نَجْعَلَ الْأَرْضَ مِهَادًا. Haven't we made this earth a vast place, right? And we created you in pairs. Allah is not a pair. You are in pairs. وَخَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا وَجَعَلْنَا نَوْمَكُمْ سُبَاتًا. And we gave you a sleep that is going to be a rest for you. وَجَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ لِبَاسًا وَجَعَلْنَا النَّهَارَ مَعَاشًا. We made the night and the day. The night is a time of rest. The day when you're earning your rizq, sustenance. In the night we feel sleepy, we find rest. In the day we have the energy to go and get our rizq. So the one who created the heavens and earth, the night and the day, can he not recreate? Can he not bring it again? وَجَعَلْنَا نُومَكُمْ سُبَاتًا وَجَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلِ لِبَاسًا وَجَعَلْنَا النَّهَارَ مَعَاشًا وَبَنَيْنَا فَوْقَكُمْ سَبْعًا شِدَادًا. We made in front and ahead of you and on top of you so many layers of heavens. وَجَعَلْنَا سِرَاجًا وَهَّاجًا. This is the sun. We made the sun a blazing light. So this power of the sun that gives you light and energy, it brings about photosynthesis. The power of the one who placed the sun there, surely that one can bring life again. وَجَعَلْنَا سِرَاجًا وَهَّاجًا وَأَنزَلْنَا مِنَ الْمُعْصِرَاتِ مَاءً ثَجَّاجًا لِنُخْرِجَ بِهِ حَبًّا وَنَبَاتًا وَجَنَّاتٍ أَلْفَافًا. All of this is about the rain coming down and the crops growing and the dense forests. So Allah is talking about the miracle of the crops and the animals and our engagement with the creation around us. So Allah Azza wa Jalla brings all of these points to tell us about the creation, and then Allah Azza wa Jalla brings another argument, and that is what we call in English the moral argument. What is the moral argument? The moral argument of the Day of Judgment is that, okay, there's an argument of the creation, there's an argument of life itself, then there's an argument of common sense and morality. إِنَّ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ مَفَازًا. Those that are righteous, they deserve a reward, right? لِلْطَّاغِينَ مَآبًا. Those that are unrighteous, right? Those that are evil, they should go to Jahannam. This is called the moral argument. What is the moral argument? The moral argument is that look around you, life is not fair. We all know this, right? Life is not fair. We feel it sometimes. That why is it that that evil person gets away with his crime? Why is it that sometimes the worst criminals, they live the best lives? And the most pious and righteous, they're not living good lives. So we feel something. And this feeling, in and of itself, if we don't believe in an akhirah, it cannot be explained. But once you believe in a hereafter, and you realize that this life is a test, and you realize the righteous will be rewarded, and the wicked and the evil shall be punished. This is the moral argument for the hereafter. And Allah uses it in this surah and in many other surahs in the Quran. That Allah says in the Quran, أَفَنَجْعَلُ الْمُتَّقِينَ كَالْمُجْرِمِينَ أَفَنَجْعَلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ كَالْمُجْرِمِينَ مَا لَكُمْ كَيْفَ تَحْكُمُونَ. Are we going to make the righteous like the criminal? What is the matter with you? How are you thinking? مَا لَكُمْ كَيْفَ تَحْكُمُونَ. This is a very powerful verse. That are we going to make the righteous and the criminals the same, right? أَمْ نَجْعَلُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ كَالْمُفْسِدِينَ فِي الْأَرْضِ, right? أَمْ نَجْعَلُ الْمُتَّقِينَ كَالْفُجَّارِ. Do you think, Allah is asking, we are going to make those who do good and those who live righteous lives the same as those who are causing evil in the earth? Or do you think that the muttaqeen and the fujjar should be the same? This is a powerful question. Explain to me, O mankind, explain to me, where is justice if it's not going to be in the hereafter? So this is then mentioned in Surah Naba as well, that Allah Azza wa Jal mentions that those that are righteous are going to be rewarded, mafaza, they shall be the ones that are rewarded. And those that are unrighteous, the taghin, those that are evil, they're going to go to Jahannam. And then obviously the descriptions of heaven and hell is another reality that underscores belief in Qiyamah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concludes this surah with a threat or a warning that if you're not going to listen to this, then there's only one option, and that is you shall regret on the day of judgment. You shall regret that you didn't think about these things. So Allah is warning the Quraysh, and through the Quraysh, all of us, because these verses, even though they primarily apply to those who reject Qiyamah, at some level, they will also apply to those who don't prepare for Qiyamah. And that category, we seek Allah's refuge. We can be in that category. We don't want to be, but we can be in that category. Inshallah, we all believe in Qiyamah. And that's great, alhamdulillah. But many amongst us haven't prepared for it. So by warning the Quraysh, Allah is indirectly warning us as well. And يَوْمَ يَقُومُ الْرُوحُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ صَفًّا. Allah describes on the Day of Judgment, Jibreel and the angels, all of them will be standing in ranks and rows. And on that day, they themselves will not speak unless Allah allows them to speak. Meaning, O Quraysh, do you think you will be able to argue with Allah on the Day of Judgment? Do you think you, because we find this arrogance even to this day, a'udhu billah, you find it in agnostics and atheists and whatnot. If there is a God, I will ask Him on the Day of Judgment, why did He do this? A'udhu billah, you think you will have the gall, the audacity? On that day, Jibreel is going to be silent. On that day, the entire malaika will be terrified. Sallim, Allahumma sallim. And now this fool comes along and he thinks, if there's a God, I'm going to challenge Him. This is just arrogance, and the Quran negates this arrogance. On that day, all of the creation, فَلَا تَسْمَعُ إِلَّا هَمْسَ, you're going to hear nothing except small whisperings amongst the people. Everybody's going to be terrified. Sallim, Allahumma sallim. The only one who will speak, إِلَّا مَنْ أَذِنَ لَهُ الرَّحْمَنِ, Allah has allowed him permission. The Prophet ﷺ will speak, others will speak, Allah will allow them permission. And when they speak, they will speak the truth. وَقَالَ صَوَابًا ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمُ الْحَقِّ, this is one of the ways of proving Judgment Day. Allah's confidence, if you like, the Quran's confidence, I should say, the explicit narration, ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمُ الْحَقِّ, how can you deny it? It is the haqq. So now Allah gives the choice, فَمَنْ شَاءَ تَخَذَ إِلَى رَبِّهِ مَآبًا, now whoever wants to, if you want to accept this, you will find safety and security with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right? And whoever doesn't, and whoever rejects it, then on that day you have no one to blame but yourself. And when you see all that is happening, وَيَقُولُ الْكَافِرُ, so بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ يَدَا, every person will see what they have prepared. And the one who believes in Allah will find ma'aba, which is security. The one who rejected Allah and did not prepare, what are they going to say? Ya laytani kuntu turaba. How I wish I had never been created or recreated. How I wish I had never been here and never had to face the Day of Judgment. So Surah Naba, in a nutshell, it is a reminder about the reality of Qiyamah and the fact that we should prepare for it. And the one who prepares shall gain Allah's protection and Jannah, and the one who rejects or does not prepare will have nothing but regret. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of the faizin, of those who win on the Day of Judgment, and to protect us from those who don't prepare for that day and are going to feel regret. Jazakumullahu khair, wa assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
وحملته في فلكك المشحون يا من أحال النار حول خليله روحا وريحانا بقولك كون